Now, our On the Couch segment today requires a musical introduction, so it's over to artists Zach Coombs and Jenna Ball to musically introduce themselves.
Feel like I win when I lose. Waterloo, I was defeated, you won the war. Waterloo, promise to love you forevermore. Waterloo, couldn't escape if I wanted to. Waterloo, knowing my fate is to be with you. Could I ever refuse? I feel like I win when I lose. Waterloo, couldn't escape if I wanted to. Waterloo, knowing my fate is to be with you. Oh, 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 Waterloo, finally facing my Waterloo. Ooh, Waterloo, knowing my fate is to be with you.
And a big round of applause as our guests make themselves comfortable in a chair for the interview. You were listening to Zach Coombs and Jenna Ball, who are half of the cast of the ABBA show, which returns to the Grand Arena Grand West tomorrow night for one night only. I hope you've got your tickets already booked if you were tapping your feet along, as I suppose many of you would have been doing. Now, Zach and Jenna play Benny and Frida, respectively. They're joined on stage by Hannah Pocock as Agnetha and South African Andre Benker, who plays Bjorn. Welcome to Cape Talk. Great to have you with us.
Hi. Thanks so much.
I mean, what is it about the music of ABBA that just endures, that all these decades later we're still singing it? Our parents played it for us in the cars. We still know all the words. We teach them to our kids. Jenna, what is it, do you think, that just makes it endure?
Oh, it's just become timeless, hasn't it? It recreates itself continuously. And every time you think, oh, that could be the last generation, they ABBA themselves do something, like they bring out the second movie and then again another generation is into ABBA, and it's amazing. It's just all ages.
Zach, I mean, when do you first remember hearing ABBA for the first time?
Oh, my mother used to play it a lot when I was growing up as a kid. She used to play a lot of music, but ABBA was always like the fun time in the family, mm-hmm. to dance around. And my aunties were huge into ABBA as well, so it was always there. Always a lot of fun to listen to. And that's what the music is. It's fun. That's why people like it.
Well, that's the thing. You it puts a smile on your face. And I mean, you put a smile on my face from a very grim start to our show today. That's what it does. This is a production by Showtime Australia. I can hear an Aussie accent there from you, I think.
G'day, mate. How's it going?
Right. But obviously an international cast, and lovely to hear that there's a South African included. How long have you all been performing together?
We've been doing this for 3 years.
Yeah. been a while.
And talk to us about the journey there, Jenna. I mean, was this something you heard about the show and went, I want to do that because I love the music, or was something you fell into and found that you loved so much you've stuck with it?
Yeah, I mean, I've been singing ABBA in tribute shows since 2012. So, yeah, I heard of the ABBA show through Hannah Pocock. She was already in the show. And when it was time for a space for a Frida, you know, I got recommended and it was great to join the show.
I have to compliment you on the accent and the singing, because I don't, I pick up there some traces of Frida's, there's something very particular about the pronunciation of the S in particular that the Swedes
do. Yes, they roll their R's as well, you know, little things like that. We try
How
and get in.
How hard is that to do while you're focusing? I mean, singing along, trying to stay in tune, keep up with everyone, keep coordinated, and then have in the back of your mind, I've got to pronounce this as if I'm Swedish.
I think it's like built into my brain now. Okay. Like when you're learning the songs, you spend so much time listening and trying to fine tune that. But after a while, it just becomes like second nature to you sing like that.
The audience is, Zach, I mean, how long have you been traveling with the show now?
I've been for 3 years
three
now.
Years, you
and
said,
the audiences for ABBA are always crazy. Yeah, they always like to dress up, and we encourage everybody to dress up tomorrow and Saturday night. But yeah, it's just always a lot of fun. Always get a lot of interesting characters.
I'm putting money on the fact that the costume shops in Cape Town have already dusted off the ABBA outfits. I know they're there. Waiting for tomorrow night. Zach, I believe you are, in your own right, a very acclaimed impersonator. You were part of the Beatlemania World Tour before this.
Yep.
How do you slip in and out of character from a show like that to a show like this?
I mean, I just act like myself, and they give me a guitar and I act like a rock star, and it just seems to work. You know? Starting with Beatles was here around about a year and a half ago now, and basically exactly what I said, just acting like a rock star. And
it's a hard life, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Gotta hang out with this one every day.
All jokes aside, it is a hard life being on tour with a show like this. You're away from home for long stretches at a time. You're living out of a suitcase. Talk to us about the pressures of being on tour, Jenna.
Well, it's like a family, really, when you're on tour. That's it. We're all there together, sickness and health and everything. But we love it because we love to travel. We love to see places. It's my first time in Cape Town, so I'm so excited to be here. And that's the big highlight. But yeah, it's hard. I mean, Hannah and I, we actually flew back to the UK just for 3 days to see our family because we hadn't been home for 3 years for Christmas.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, that kind of says it all. I mean, is it much the same for you, Zach?
I tend to travel quite a lot. Consistently going to flying back home to Australia would have been a bit tough considering it's so far away. That's pretty much it. Yep.
It must be hard to be away from home at a time like this, though, when your country is facing such immense pressure.
It was a pretty close call with some of my family and friends as well. But luckily, everything was good on that front. But it's just one of those times. It's just catastrophic over there at the moment.
Yeah, I'm glad to hear that your loved ones are all okay.
Yeah.
Let's talk a bit about the show and what fans can expect. So, I mean, the big hits, how many of them can you cram into one show? Because you've got such a big playlist to choose from, Jenna.
Yes, it's a 2.5-hour show with an interval. We cram in all the favourites. It's been really fun as well because with the second Mamma Mia movie coming out, Mamma Mia, Here We Go Again, there's a couple of hits from that we sneak into the show that maybe weren't as well-known before. But the show is obviously the four main cast with a live band. The lighting is sensational. We have a fabulous LED wall behind us, which really adds to the nostalgia of ABBA in there as well. And we have a little surprise for everybody just because we're in South Africa in the show as well. Something special just for here. It's a big production. And what we want is just everybody to just enjoy it, get up, dance, sing, and have a great time.
It sounds amazing. The movie, the impact of the movie, as you said, has had the knock-on effect of bringing a whole new generation of audiences. Are you seeing that reflected in the audiences coming to the show, that there are young people coming as well as the mums and dads?
Last show we did was a Sunday matinee, and I mean, the audience was full of little tiny ones. Sweet. And they had their ABBA t-shirts on, and they were like so excited to meet us after the show and stuff. It was great.
That's really cute.
Yeah.
Zach, is there any input at all or endorsement from the actual members of ABBA who are all still with us? Have they had any say in
Well,
the
if
show?
They're out there, they're free to call us if they want to. Because we'd love to hear from them. But not as of yet, but we're waiting.
I mean, I'm just thinking how amazing it would be and perhaps how terrifying if you were to look up one night and see them sitting in the audience.
Oh,
what it would be like
for you. I can't imagine, but I would love to meet Frieda.
He'd love my shoes, I reckon.
Okay. Yeah, definitely. You rock those, Zach.
Oh, okay, those are impressive. Yeah, I have no doubt he would approve. let's talk about your own personal favourite songs, whether they're the ones that you love because they're the ones you grew up singing or because they're the ones you like performing in the show. Jenna, let's start with you.
So The Winner Takes It All will always be a favourite of mine. Makes me think of my dad. He always played that song, so I love doing that one. But then I love the lively ones, and I'd have to say Mamma Mia has just always been a favourite of mine.
Okay. How about you, Zach?
Yeah, the first ABBA song that I remember really liking was Rock Me, because it had that it had that Bjorn hard edge vocal to it, and I was just like, oh, that's an ABBA? I didn't think it was like that. So yeah, I love playing Waterloo. That's one of my favourites as well. And Mamma Mia, for some reason live, I love playing that song.
I would imagine the audience response to that one must be...
It's the vibe. I love it when when the audience always join in and they copy our moves and they do the little Mamma Mia fingers. I love that.
You've just given me such a flashback to my own childhood by mentioning Rock Me, because it's an ABBA song I haven't heard in years and I haven't thought about in years. But I immediately you said those words was transported back to the front seat of my mom's ghastly yellow-coloured Beetle hurtling down the hills of East London listening to Rock Me as a five-year-old. So it's I mean, that is what this music is. It's instant nostalgia. It transports you back to a sort of a lighter feeling. That's what it's all about, really. It's a feeling of lightness. It's nothing too heavy, nothing too serious to worry about. You come to a show like this and leave your troubles at the door, don't you?
Yes, definitely. That's what it's all about. Yeah.
So we want our listeners to do exactly that. Let me run you through some ticketing info before we give you one more musical sample of the show that lies ahead. Tickets are available from either CompuTicket or ShopRite. They're priced from 180 Rand each. Doors open at 7 o'clock and the show begins at 8. It's a one-night only show at Grand West Grand Arena tomorrow night. And if you're looking for more information, please go onto Facebook and simply type in The ABBA Show for more info. Interesting question from one of our listeners wanting to know your thoughts on the virtual reality ABBA tour that was announced a year or so ago. Nothing seems to have come of it yet, but what do you think of the idea?
Oh, sorry, I just missed that then.
Oh, sorry, okay. I don't know exactly.
I was looking at
yours. So the virtual reality, apparently they've written new material for that as well. It just got released. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I know. We're still waiting on that. I got excited last year that new material was coming out.
Would you go and see it for the sake of the song?
Absolutely, yeah. I went all the way to Stockholm just to go to the ABBA Museum.
You did?
Yeah.
What was it like?
Amazing.
Did it live up to expectations?
It was so fun.
Okay.
It was great. I actually got to do karaoke in front of everyone and people were clapping. And I was like, yeah, I've never done this before.
No, just off the cuff, spur of the moment kind of thing. Okay, so we're going to ask you to play out the segment, and the song you've chosen to do for us unaccompanied is Why Did It Have to Be Me? Why did it have to be this track?
Well, like I said before, with Mamma Mia, Here We Go Again, this is a song that's been really popular in the second movie that wasn't as well known before. And seeing as it's Frieda and Bjorn in the studio, it was a lovely duet that they did.
Well, it's over to Frieda and Bjorn, otherwise known as Jenna Ball and Zach Coombs, playing us out for now with ABBA's Why Did It Have to Be Me?
When you were lonely, you needed a man, someone to lean on. Well, I understand.
It's only natural, but why did it have to be me?
Nights can be empty and nights can be cold, so you were looking for someone to hold.
That's only natural, but why did it have to be me? I was so lonesome, I was blue. I couldn't help it, it had to be you and I. Always thought you knew the reason why. I always wanted a little love affair. Now I see you are beginning to care. But baby, believe me, it's better to forget me.
Clap your hands in the studio, you know what to do.
Woo!
Oh yeah, oh, I hope so too. Men are toys in the games that you play. When you get tired, you throw them away.
That's only natural, but why did it have to be me? Falling in love with a woman like you happens so quickly, there's nothing to do. It's only natural, but why did it have to be me?
I was so lonesome, I was blue. I couldn't help it, it had to be you and I. Always thought you knew the reason why.
I was wanted a little love affair. Now I see you are beginning to care. But baby, believe me, it's better to forget me. Woo.
Round of applause from the studio and no doubt from those listening at home. So that was Zach Coombs and Jenna Ball, who are half of the cast of the ABBA show. Looking forward to the performance. It's one night only, Cape Town. Don't do that Cape Town thing and think, nah, I'll wait until there's a second show added to the run. That's not happening. So get your tickets now. A reminder that they're available through CompuTicket. The show is tomorrow night at the Grand West Grand Arena. Doors will open at 7 p.m. and the show starts at 8. Final question to Zach and Jenna. I don't know how much time you've got in Cape Town, but anything you're hoping to do while you're here?
I really want to see the penguins. I've heard it's amazing at Boulder's Beach
is where you need to be. Okay,
I'm waiting for your top five of things to do.
Well, I was gonna say go up the cable car, but it's closed today because I believe the winds up there are over 100 kilometers an hour, so I hope that is a possibility for you a little bit later in the trip. So thank you so much for visiting us here at Cape Talk, and hope you have a wonderful show tomorrow evening.
Thanks for having us.
The ABBA show on at the Grand West Grand Arena tomorrow night for one night only, brought to you by Showtime Australia.